In today's tutorial, we'll knit the Trellis and Tassels Knit Afghan by Yarnspirations.com. Welcome back to another Yarnspirations tutorial. I'm your host, Kristen Mangus of GoodKnitKisses. Let's get started. In today's tutorial, you'll need a super bulky or 6-weight yarn, 220 yards. We're using Bernat blanket yarn, 5 balls of the main color, pale gray, 2 balls of contrast A, vintage white. To get your knit pattern, click on the link below to get the Trellis and Tassels Knit Afghan downloaded from yarnspirations.com. It's going to be a 2-page sheet and you're going to want this for reference. To make your Trellis and Tassels Knit Afghan, you're going to need your yarn, 5 balls of your main color, and 2 balls of your contrast color in Bernat blanket. You're going to need 40 inches or 101 and a half centimeters of a US size 11 or 8 millimeter circular needle. You'll also need a size L or 8 millimeter crochet hook, some scissors, a stitch marker, and maybe a tapestry needle, although I'm going to show you how you don't even need that. Before we cast on, I just want to show you that what we're going to be working today. We've got a multiple of 8 plus 7. Your full cast on is 127 stitches for the full Afghan. I'm going to cast on 31 stitches to make a small 1/5 the size little blanket to show you. The stitches that we're going to cover are knitting and purling. We will also knit 5 together, go from 5 stitches down to 1, and then we'll go from 1 stitch to 5 stitches with the knit front, back, front, back, front. We'll cover exactly how to do that. So let's get started on the pattern. We're going to cast on 127 stitches for your full Afghan, and I'm going to do 31 for a sample. A quick tip before you get started, make sure to use a metal needle as it will slide along with this yarn better than a wood needle, specifically a bamboo. There's too much drag on the bamboo, and this will slide quite nicely and make your project go faster. And we're going to start with a slip knot, and whatever cast on you decide to use, make sure it's very loose. We want to give it a little extra give because this yarn isn't going to start off that way. It will get stretchier as we go along in our stitch work. I'm going to extend my thumb out here and put it on this part that I'm pulling a little tighter, put it down and flip, and then scoop it up onto your needle, and then pull that to match your first loop. Okay, put our thumb down, twist and scoop and put it on. You're just going to continue this backwards loop cast on until you have 127 stitches, and I'm going to do 31 for my smaller sample. We'll meet you back in a moment. Row 1, the first stitch is a knit stitch and it falls before the asterisk on our pattern. And so that asterisk section is the part that's going to get repeated. So the repeated part is going to be 8 stitches, and then that part gets repeated over and over until the last 6 stitches. We're going to purl 5 stitches consecutively. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and after you purl, you want to make sure and put your yarn to the back. We're going to knit. Okay, that's knit, and then purl. So if you need to purl slower, I do have a slower video on my channel if you'll check that out, and I'll put a link in the description below. We want to make sure and put the yarn to the front. We put our needle through the front here of this leg of the stitch, wrap around for our yarn over, and then we're just pushing that yarn over through to the other side. Let it slip off. And we're going to go back to a knit. Okay, so these 3 stitches that were past the purl are always going to be knit, purl, knit. Okay, on other rows, we're going to be doing the opposite. Okay, so now we're going to switch over to this repeat. So we're going to purl for 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then the next 3 is knit, purl, knit. And I just sit there and say to myself, 1, 2, 3,
even though they're not the same. So I say knit, it's one, purl, two, and then three is knit. I'm going to do that repeat over and over again until I get to where I have six stitches remaining. And then we're just going to purl those stitches and purl five, just like we would continue, except when we finish with a knit. So keep doing that, and I'll meet you back at the end and show you those last six stitches. Okay, we have six stitches left. Now, even if you forgot the rest of this pattern and you're just in the sequence of purling five after you finish that sequence of eight, you'll just notice you only have one left on your needle. So I'm just purling five here. Two, three, four, five. And then I would normally do a knit, purl, knit, but I just have this knit left, and that's all you need to do. So we're going to put our yarn to the back, knit that stitch. Remember, if you don't put the yarn to the back, it can cause an increase and then your stitch count would be off. Before we turn it around, I want to note which side is the right side. So I'm going to put this down towards the beginning, make sure everything is laid out with the cast on edge at the bottom. And I'm just going to stick this into one of the stitches here. I'm going to put it in a purl bump here. Okay, and that's just going to show you our right side row, and also the fact that it's row one of a 12 row repeat. If you know where row one is, then if you have to move backwards, you'll know or count which row you're on. So that can be very important. You can move this up as you go. All right, let's turn this around, and we're going to work on the second row. On row two, it's basically the same thing. We're working backward, but we're working in the opposite stitch so that we get the same look that we just created to be repeated. So we're going to purl one instead of knit one, and then we're going to knit five. We've got one, two, three, four, and five, and this starts our asterisk repeated section. So now that we've knitted, we're going to do the opposite. So we're going to purl, knit, purl here for our three, purl, knit. Remember to move that yarn back and forth on those three, purl, and then we're going to repeat our knit five. And then after we repeat the knitted five, that completes that asterisk section. And you're going to repeat those eight stitches along until you have one stitch left. And that stitch is going to be purl, just like the very front stitch. So continue on until you get to row three, and I'll meet you back in a moment. Okay, we're back on a right side row. You can see my stitch marker. And we're going to repeat row one, just as we did before. We'll knit the first stitch and then purl five. And then knit, purl, knit for that repeat. So just as you did before, work your row, and I'll meet you back in a moment after you pause your video. We're ready to work row four. Now row four and row 10 are basically the same. We're just gonna flip-flop which one is performed first. So we are going to work this together. I'll show you slowly how to make the more difficult stitches, and you'll see how we're going to increase and decrease in the same row. The first stitch is purl one. Okay, this next stitch is a knit five together. We're going to put our yarn towards the back. Knit five together is when we gather five stitches and knit them all as one stitch. We're going from five stitches down to one stitch. So I'm going to go through the front of all these stitches here. Okay, it's quite bulky, and so I'm going to make sure you can see the tip of both of my needles here. Can you see these two tips here? Okay, so I'm going to yarn over and put it right in between there. And what I like to do is I pull on here, and then I slide these two tips with this one grazing way under and just brushing along the inside of it. Make sure that I don't drop a stitch. Pull that off, and you can see that they are all gathered here together. Okay, it has this sort of shell look to it. And now we're going to purl in between. We're always going to purl in between these stitches. Yarn to the back. Okay, this next stitch is a knit front back, front back, front. So we're going to work into the front of the stitch, knit it, and pull it long. I like to get a lot of extra slack because I'm going to be working back and forth, and this yarn doesn't have as much give. Now I'm going to rotate and go into the back of this stitch. I'm going to yarn over, pull it through. Okay, and now I've got a second loop. I'm going to pull out, give myself a little bit more slack, and then we're going to put our stitch in here, right into the front of this, just like we normally do. We're going to knit it, pull that loop on through. Now we have three stitches. We're going to go rotate to the back. Okay, put that stitch on through. See how that's just right at the back of there? And knit in the back. It twists this stitch. That's what it does. Okay, we've got four on here. One, two, three, four. And now we need to go into the front. So we're going to go. I usually like to put my finger here and go to the back. And you see me pulling it back here. I do that because I don't want it to fall off. So then I'm going to work in the back here. And I just prevent it from going anywhere by holding my fingers on it. Wrap around and pull that on through. I like to guide the tip of this needle through the back of here. And here we go. It's right on here. And then slide it off. And that will give you that extra slack that you need. Now you have all five of these stitches together, so this big cluster. So you've got all these worked here, you've got a purl stitch in between, and then you've got this big grouping here. And we're going to purl between, and then we're going to repeat that. Okay, so then we want to knit five together, and we're going to continue working knit five, purl one, then we're going to increase so that we knit front, back, front, back, front, and then purl. So we're going to continue that on row four all the way to the last stitch, which is going to be purl. Okay, let's knit this together again. Work through the bottom of all these stitches. It makes a teardrop on your needle, so you can work into that teardrop there. I like to hold it on. Make sure none of these fall off. Yarn over around my needle here. And then pull it on through, and if I drop it, do it again. If you're a tight knitter like I am, you might need a little bit extra wiggle. It's a big stitch. And then pull that on through, slide it off, and you've got your stitch here, and we're going to purl. And then we're going to knit front, back, front, back, front. Here we go. One more of this increase here. Knit in the front, knit in the back, knit in the front, knit in the back, knit in the front. And then we're done with that stitch. Continue that on, and I'll meet you back on the fifth row. Okay, we're on the fifth row, which is a right side row, and I want to take a moment to explain what's happening. That way you understand it in your own knitting. So if you notice on the right side, we do a lot of purling. What's going to do is it's going to make this little spine stand out here, and you'll start to notice it. But the reason why we have the purls and then opening it up to these knit front back as it spreads it out, and it makes that trellis start appearing. So every time we're on a right side row and we are coming after one of these fourth or tenth rows, you're going to be purling all five of these here. So you'll see that pattern of eight showing up here, where we've got three that we work alternating a knit, purl, and knit stitch, and then we're going to purl these five together and then continue that pattern on until the end. All right, so let's continue that now. We're going to knit one, purl one, knit one, and then purl. And it's going to be tighter here because you're going to get this evening out. This is 3, 4, 5, and then because we just purled, we're gonna knit. So knit 1, purl 1, knit 1, and then now we're at another grouping, so we know we're going to purl those together because we want the majority of our purls to be on our right side to let that trellis show up. So hopefully that can help you remember what you're to do. You may not need to look at your pattern once you get this kind of stuck in your head, although a pattern is really great. I will say that moving up your stitch marker once you get the 12th row complete, moving that up to that 12th row, you'll know where you stand in the pattern. If you get a little lost, you can always count up your rows and see where you need to be. So I finished those up, and now I'm gonna go back to my knit, purl, knit, and continue on. Continue in your Afghan and pause your video, and I'll meet you back on the 6th row. The 6th row starts off on a purl, knit, purl, and then knitting 5. Basically, you're going to be following along what you did on this side of your work. So if you see a purl stitch, you're going to purl it. If you see a knit stitch, you're going to knit it. So we've got a purl, knit, purl, and then where we had that sequence of purls on the opposite row, now it's showing a knit on this side, so we're going to knit those 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we're just going to work that pattern until the end, and then you'll end on a purl 1 stitch. So continue on yours, and I'll meet you back in a moment. Pause your video. Okay, we're on the 7th row, and we're just going to keep repeating back and forth between the 5th and 6th row, and all we're doing is making this longer. So we're going to knit the knits and purl the purls for row 7, 8, and 9. So 7 is going to look just like 5, then we're going to do an 8th row, and it's going to look just like we did the 6th row, and then the 9th row is going to be just like the 5th row. Come back when you are ready to make row 10. Pause your video and I'll see you in a moment. Okay, I've just finished the 9th row, and before I turn it over, I want you to notice, of course, this is a right side. You see where we had pulled the stitches in and knit 5 together, and then we had expanded it out. So what happened down here is we closed it in certain areas and opened it other areas. So on the row 9, we are at the end of how we're reinforcing the length here. And on row 10, this area is going to get squished together again. Okay, and then this is going to expand more. And so we're going to have the push and pull and create that serpentine or trellis effect here. So now we're going to move on to row 10, and we're doing the opposite that we did in row 4. So this time we're going to purl 1, same as we did before, except instead of knitting 5 together first, we're going to do the increase. So we're going to increase from 1 to 4, which is the knit in the front. Hold it there. Go twist to the back and knit in the back. Go to the front. Knit that front. Go to the back. Knit the back. And one more. Twist and knit in the front. All right, we've made that increase. And now we're going to reinforce the in-between area with the purl. Okay, that creates that trellis. Go to the back with your yarn, and we're going to knit these 5 together. So find your 5 stitches, pull them all together. I like to get more stitches on here, otherwise I'm stretching it too much. I'm going to go right in, pick these stitches up with our needle, yarn over, and pull that right on through, and slide it off. I like to kind of straighten my work up, and then you can see that pull right in together. This little pillow is going to be created, this little pocket. It's going to pop to this back side here, the wrong side with you. It won't go to the front, and it'll end up doing that on the back here. So let's do a few more and get this down. We're going to purl, knit, front, back, front, back, front. So pull this out to get that extra slack. Go to the back. Go to the front again. Go to the back. Notice I'm holding in. I'm using my thumbs a lot. I'm holding it on. Make sure I get extra slack and they don't come off the needles. Knit this last front one. Okay. All right. Then add that purl in here. Okay. And then we're going to knit five together again. So you're going to keep increasing this. I'll show you one more for the decrease. Pick all these up. Even if you can't pull it on through, it's just the little tip. That's all you need. And then push that tip against the other needle so you can get it all through. Slide it off. And you've now created another one of these. All right. So just keep working on that. And we'll meet you back on the other side for the last two rows. Pause your video and I'll see you in a moment. Okay, we are on the 11th row here, and you can see it's starting to come together again, and you will be repeating the first row. However, on this row, just like on the after the fourth row, wherever you see the groupings of five together, that's going to be purled. So we're going to knit the knits and purl the purls on these rows here, but the way you're doing it is you are reinforcing what's just been done on the row before. We're going to knit that first stitch there and purl this grouping of five. So we're purling five just as it's written for row one. Three, four, five. Okay, then we're going to do the sequence of three here with the knit, purl, knit. Okay, now we've got another grouping of five, so we're going to purl five. It's the same as it was before, but now you have this little grouping to remind you. So when I see this big tight grouping together, I know that I need to purl those because we're on a right side row and I want to reinforce it. Got one more. And then we're going to knit, purl, and knit. And then let's take a moment and we'll look and see what this looks like on this row. Okay, let's step out and look at our work. See how it's continuing to draw in and reinforce that. Okay, so it's pulled that in, and then this will continue to expand and get bigger just as this part did before. So continue on your row and then repeat the 12th row, knitting the knits and purling the purls. It's a repeat of the second row. And then you will be finished with your 12 row repeat. Okay, so let's just keep going and I'll meet you back in a little bit. I have completed my 12 rows. Here is where I want you to move your stitch marker. Going to take that, move it, just put it somewhere up here right after one of these purl stitches that just happened on the other side, and that marks the beginning of where you will start your next row. So every time you complete your 12th row, I want you to go ahead and move this upward, and then you'll know where a 12th row ends. I'm going to do a few more repeats and I'll show you what this overall patterning is looking like, and I hope you're enjoying it so far. It's really going to work up nicely. Keep going. You've got this. This is what my sample looks like after about four pattern repeats. You can see the beginning. The first repeat hits about here. The second 12 rows hit here. the third, and then the fourth. So you're going to continue your pattern on until you reach about 62 inches or 157 centimeters, and you will end after finishing a 12th row. So you'll be on the back. This is the reverse. So look at that cool design there, which is really cool in itself. And so we're going to finish that up, and then we turn it over and we're going to bind off. So pause your video and get your Afghan where it needs to be, and I'll meet you back up and finish this off together. Ready to bind off? We're going to bind off in pattern. After the 12th row, we're going to go backwards. So this last stitch on the, it was a repeat of a second row. It's actually the 12th row, but it's a repeat. So it was a purl. So we're actually going to knit this stitch here. Okay. So knit this stitch. And then the next five stitches were purls, so we're going to purl those. But we're only going to purl one starting off. Okay, then we're going to lift this first loop over the top and bind it off. And then we're going to purl the next stitch. So this is two. Lift that up and over. Three. What I'm counting is those five purls in a row. Four. Five. Okay. And then I have the sequence of knit, purl, knit. So we're going to knit, purl, knit, and back to the sequence of five. So we're going to purl five. We're going to continue this bind off until the end. Pause your video and I'll meet you back with your end of your cast off, and we'll do the last few stitches together. Okay, we've got these last couple stitches left. I've just purled this last stitch, so we're going to do one more in a knit stitch. Knit that last stitch, move the back over the top. Okay, and then we're just going to pull this on through. You go ahead and break your yarn. And that we can weave in. And go ahead and set your needles aside and get your contrast yarn out. We're going to get started on that. Okay, once you have finished binding off, you're going to want to grab your contrast yarn. I've got vintage white, and we're going to be working a surface slip stitch stripe. It's going to go up and down all of these areas here to make it have this little cool serpentine look and maybe make this accent. Okay, and so at the bottom of here, wherever they squiggle and come together, there, that's where we're going to have tassels. We're also going to put one on the very edge here, and there'll be a tassel on the end. Now, I've already made up several tassels, and I have a way of attaching them without sewing them, but the pattern calls for making the tassels up after you've put all the slip surfaces on, and then you sew them on. If you don't want to sew, I'm going to show you another alternate to do that right now. You can choose to ignore this step and sew it in later if you like. We're going to take our crochet hook. This is a size L, US L, or 8mm. And we've got our contrast color here. We're going to make a slip knot. Okay. And we're going to put our hook in and tighten that up and go to the right side, the very right bottom corner here. And I'm going to be holding my yarn in the back. All right. And we're going to go right through this side here. And when I go through this first stitch here, I'm going to make sure I'm grabbing with a couple on the edge here, okay? So this is like the edge of your chain. And we're going to wrap around and come through the back, through the front of this stitch here. And then we're going to slip that first stitch here, okay? So we're going to do that all here. Now, this is the option without adding the tassel in. We're going to go through this knit stitch here, wrap around the back, pull through and make a slip stitch, and we're going to go all the way up this spine here. I'm going to show you how to start it off with the tassel and end with the tassel, and that way you can get that that solved without sewing. I'll show you after I'm done how to make the tassel, so hold on for that, and mark the place in the pattern where you can get that information, and also in the video, and you can jump to that later. Okay, so I'm going to undo this, meet you back in a second when I'm ready. Okay, so after you've made your tassels, you're going to want to have this area here where you have had this top part, okay, that you've sewn it all together. You're going to want to go up through this back area here where this has knotted off. We're going to grab those, pull them through like this, and let it slide all the way down like that. Okay, and you can trim this off even afterwards, and now you've got this little knot at the top that you can slip through. Okay, very easy. So I've already done this one here like that. I'm ready to start. I'm going to slip this on. Okay, I'm going to slipping this onto my hook, then I'm going to put my slip knot on. Tighten that up, and now we're going to hold our working yarn at the back just as before, and then go through this first chain down here, making sure there's two on here. I'm going to wrap around this working yarn and pull that straight on through that knit stitch here, okay, and then we're going to slip this stitch onto that working yarn. And then slip the tassel on. Whoops. And you should just have that loop left that's from your yarn here in the back. Okay. And then we're going to go straight into the next stitch and wrap around in the back and pull it through that gray and then pull through this loop here. We're going to do that again. Go through the back, pull that yarn that's in the back through, and slip stitch through the front. Okay, and you're just going to keep going on like this and grabbing that yarn through the back and slipping it through the front, and make sure to check and make that you are not getting too tight, but you're going up through the spine, so you'll notice that you've got your main color on either side of it, and it's going to make this cool ridge. So I'll show you what this looks like at the very end. Just continue on and pause your video. I'll meet you back in just a moment. All right, I'm at the end of this line here, and we're going to go in this last stitch and pull on through. Okay, and now that I'm the very, very tip here, and where you'd think, okay, normally if I didn't have the tassel, I could just go ahead and take this and pull this on through and break my yarn. But because I've got my tassel already made, I'm going to go ahead and put this on here as if I'm going to go into another stitch. So I'm going to go on the top of this one because that's how I did it on the last one. So I'm going to go through this little part I've already worked in here. Going to wrap my yarn around and pull all the way through and just slip it like I would on that first one. And now is where I'm going to fasten off. So I'm going to yarn over and pull it on through, and then go ahead and break my yarn. Okay, tighten that up. And now I can actually pull this on through with my hook. And I'm gonna pull it all the way down into there. Okay, and if I really wanna fasten it off, I can go back up through here for good measure a couple more times. And then pull it on through. And so now it is nice and attached. It's not going anywhere. And then I can just cut these off and straighten them up when I'm done. And so now we're ready to go on to the next one. We're going to go down to the bottom again. And you're going to start at one end and go ahead and add that tassel in. And you're going to follow all this all the way down to the other end and add your tassel in. And then when you come over here, you don't need to add a tassel. You're just going to attach them. So I'm going to work on these next couple and show you what that looks like. I'm going to finish this one and then we'll come to this one. I'll show you how to address that. Okay, I finished this one and you can see how it's starting to shape up. And this trellis here, this is half of a trellis here because we're going to make this other part that goes with it because these two get connected, not these two. So it's got this open area here where all the purls were. So first one I want to do is, this is where we connected them earlier, and I'm just going to add on this last bit here and go ahead and pull this on through. And I can weave this in later or put it inside right now just by going like this and pulling it through. And look at that, it's already attached. And then I want to grab the end here and have my slip knot ready. And I'm going to go straight through this again, okay? And I'm going to put my slip knot on, okay? And then go through the top side of this trellis here, all right? And then we're going to pull the barking yarn from the back just as we've been doing, not the tail, but the yarn here from the that's attached to the ball. Pull that through and make a slip knot. And make it a slip stitch, not a slip knot. Pull it through that first slip knot and then go ahead and pull it on through that tassel, and that's going to draw this up together. See how that attached now? And then we're going to go through that next stitch and yarn over in the back, which you can't see right here, but it's just yarning over like this. And then so just continue working up as we are. I'll show you how to make a tassel here in this next clip. Pause your video and I'll see you in a minute. To make the tassel, you're going to follow the directions in the pattern. I've done it just a little bit differently, and they want a little bit of an extra bulk on here, and I will do that after. However, I'm showing it with this extra piece off of it at the moment. I'm going to show you how to make it like this because you'll be able to use this, as I'm showing earlier in the video, connecting them easier. So I'm going to set aside this extra and show you that after. I'm going to cut across about two 9-inch lengths here. One will be for the top and one will be to the join here. And I want to measure around this cardboard 12 times. The cardboard is 12.5 centimeters or 5 inches high and about 6 inches wide, just a little wider. I'm going to take one of my little pieces up top here and measure by putting my yarn at the bottom, and we're going to go around 12 times. And every time I go to the bottom, I'm count 1, 2, 3, move that aside, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, okay, 12. So we're going around 12, and then I'm going to cut this, and I'm going to tie this end here. Tie that and go ahead and cut this end here. And then while this is still together, I want to take my other small piece of yarn that I had previously cut and lay this on top. And about 1.5 inches down, I'm going to tie this knot, okay, and then I'm actually just going to go ahead and cut this. And then I show in the other part of the video where you're going to actually just work this back into the tassel and use it that way. Or you can tie it in and sew in these little parts later on and secure them. Then the way that you finish them off after you're done with everything, if you want to make them with the bigger, thicker, as recalled in the pattern here, you're going to take another piece of strand and go around and leave a little bitty tail here. and go around 6 times. It's already gone once around, so this is going to be 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I'm going to take this and tie it. And then I can leave my nice long tails on here. And that's what this tassel is going to look like. So it's going to have this nice, bigger, thicker look to it. Let's look at it with the rest of my sample. So I've got all of this on here except for the last one. And all of these have that smaller tassel. And so this is just going to add a little bit more weight to this tassel and make it nice and finished. So I'm going to finish this off and show you what the sample looks like after. I finished up my tassels quite nicely with this extra little bit. Go ahead and finish putting on the rest of your slip stitches and tassels and your contrast color, and you'll be done. I hope you've enjoyed your Trellis and Tassels Knit Afghan by Yarnspirations.com. On behalf of Yarnspirations and Good Knit Kisses, this is Kristen Mangus wishing you happy knitting. We'll see you next time.